We got troubles in this country. I'm telling you what the problem is. The doing something about it, responsibility is yours.
There's an old saying in Tennessee, I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once, shame on you. If fool me, we can't get fooled again.
Another thing that people have taken as a given that seems to be, that could possibly be a complete fabrication, it might be another offshoot of this Mason's plan to just siphon off a bunch of money from the space program, but also siphon a bunch of money from the nuclear weapons program. Because it seems like, and this was only brought to my attention through you and your post about it and the footage that you've shown, it seems like at least the test footage that we've seen of a lot of nuclear weapons from back in the day when they're telling our parents to duck and cover under their school desk to protect them from a nuclear blast, and you got the air raid sirens going off. Obviously, our entire culture was completely paralyzed by the idea of nuclear weapons. But when you're looking at the test footage, given back then it might not have looked fake. You know, back then they actually thought King Kong looked real in the movie, or Jaws looked real in the movie, but now we can see it's clearly fake. When you look back at that footage, it's oftentimes, it looks like the scale of, say, a subdivision where you're in an empty lot across the street aiming a camera at a farmhouse on the other side of the street, a lot over, and then the blast hits and the farmhouse just gets destroyed. The house just gets ripped apart. But what happened to the camera? You know, who's filming that? The camera is only a couple hundred feet away from that. And in some videos, man, this is the most compelling, is the blast comes from behind the camera. What the hell is that? The blast comes from behind the camera and the house gets blown away out into the background of the shot. And you're like, what kind of camera in that day and age could survive that blast, but an entire building can't? I mean, it seems way out there. You've changed my mind on a little of this. You dipped my needle further into the fringe for sure.
Yeah. So it's just another way to get us scared into giving them more money. So we're giving them hundreds of billions of dollars in this space race that America and Russia were doing. And they also did the Cold War, so they scared us into this nuclear scare and then stole a bunch more money to build fake nuclear weapons. And so, yeah, nuclear weapons don't exist as such. The tests that you've seen, the very early ones like you were talking about, are clearly fake, just done on models. Some of the later tests were done using stacked dynamite. You just get a shitload of dynamite and blow it all up, and it makes the mushroom cloud, does the whole thing. And what they'd do is they'd tell one team that, you know, they'd have a bunch of people 20 miles away, say, army guys watching, doing the test. And then you've got, over on one island, these people stacking dynamite, saying that we're doing this for comparative purposes, and the real nuke's going to be over on that island. Meanwhile, they got another team over on that island stacking dynamite for comparative purposes, and the real nuke's going to be on the other island. Have military men stacking dynamite that they know is being used for these supposed nuclear explosions, but they believe that they've seen a real nuke, even though they tell them to cover your eyes and put your head in your laps as it happens. You don't see anything until the smoke clears afterwards. But a lot of military men will swear, you know, up and down that nukes must exist because they were there at some of those tests, and it's just dynamite. They do a beneath water by stacking dynamite in submarines, and you can do it up in the air as well. The Hiroshima and Nagasaki nukes, you can see that they're clearly two superimposed explosions, one on top of each other. There's two smoke plumes made to look like they're one. I actually used this technique several times. If you look at this nuke footage, there's if you go to my website, Nuclear Weapons Do Not Exist, you'll see these three documentaries that expose the thing completely. And so not only do so for instance, in Hiroshima and Nagasaki, what happened is that they were firebombed. So the cities were leveled just like Tokyo was firebombed, and the damage is comparable. But they claim that it all happened from one blast. But this is clearly not true, because flowers and plants started growing within a month, and they say nuclear radiation would exist for hundreds, thousands of years and would cause birth defects and everything. But nowadays, Hiroshima's a bustling city. Everyone's living there. Everything's growing there. Radiation's not a problem. There is some radiation after any explosion, so you would be able to go there with a Geiger counter and get some radiation, especially right afterwards, but it dies down quite quickly. And nuclear power, one of the most prominent nuclear physicists in America, he's dead now, Galen Windsor, he was involved in setting up most of the nuclear power plants in America. And he went all over America for years giving this lecture about how nuclear power is just the most expensive and effective way to boil water. And they're essentially steam plants, and that's all it is. The nuclear component that supposedly causes all this radioactive waste that needs to be, hazmat dealt with, and they drill holes into bedrock and put the nuclear waste deep under the earth, and they've got all these crazy regulations. He says, when we were first working with nuclear material, uranium, plutonium, we held it in our hands, and if some of it got hot, we'd throw it in the water, and that was it. No problem. He said, I would bathe, I would swim in the pool there that we would throw the radiated metals into. No problem. People thought he was crazy. He started drinking a glass of water from it every day. No problems. And then in his lecture, he started eating radioactive waste. So you can see on YouTube, type in Galen Windsor, and he'll take out a Geiger counter, show you some radioactive material. He'll take it out of a tube, and they'll say, I've just caused an EPA, you know, if the EPA was in here, we'd have to clear out this whole area for half a mile, and people would have to come in with hazmat suits, blah, blah. And then he puts it back in the tube, and there's some left over on his hand. So then he licks his keep us afraid and keep us playing off one another. Everybody thinks that, you know, Russia and America are enemies and that the Cold War is real and the space race is real. But it's all just, you know, they're all like WWE. It's like Hulk Hogan and Macho Man. You know, they're all paid by Vince McMahon. They all go out to eat together. You know, if you're high up in politics anywhere, for sure you're part of this brotherhood that controls everything. There's no independent man at the head of any state. And if he was, what's he doing? Yeah, the only type of government that should exist is a government that doesn't tax or perform violence on its people. So the only kind of candidate I would vote for is someone who's for the abolition of all taxes and legislation other than common law. If you hurt or harm a person or their property, theft or breach of contract, those three things, those common laws, are the only things anyone should ever have to go to court for. Everything else is a victimless crime, and this is the big system that they get us caught up in. So they've got millions of statutes and acts that supposedly ignorance of the law is no excuse. So if you break any of these millions of legislations, they've got reasons to fine you or kidnap you and put you in jail, or even murder you if you don't pay them up. So I don't vote. I don't recommend voting. If you could get out of paying taxes, I'd recommend that too.
Wow.